Hi students, welcome to Vidyalakshmi YouTube channel. So this is your Ashok Kumar, biology faculty. So today we are going to give a YouTube class regarding a very important concept in plus one standard, that is called photosynthesis in higher plants. Okay, so first of all we have to see what is meant by photosynthesis. So everything, what are the factors required for photosynthesis, how the photosynthesis will occur. So everything we are going to see in this particular session. Okay. Yes, now we are going to see here. Yes, first of all we are going to see here is called a photosynthesis. Photosynthesis. Okay, so here we got the content is called life process. So photosynthesis is a type of life process which occurs in all green plants. Okay, so photosynthesis is done in plants with the help of essential factors. Okay, so photosynthesis is considered as a basic or very important life process which occurs in all green plants. In all green plants. Okay, so this is the definition of photosynthesis. Okay, so photosynthesis is an important life process which occurs in plants. Okay, so that is called a photosynthesis life process. Okay, so we have different types of life process which occurs in living organisms. Okay, it includes plants, animals, everything. Okay, so these life process which occurs in human beings particularly are, we have digestive system. So as of you know, digestive system. So after photosynthesis, plants can prepare the food material. So we are taking food from the plants. So that food material, whatever we are taking by digestive system, they finally convert into glucose. So that glucose molecule undergo respiratory system to produce energy. So that is the importance of digestive system and respiratory system. Okay, so first of all digestive system, then respiratory system. Okay, so the end product of human digestive system is called glucose. So that glucose molecule undergo human respiratory system to produce energy, that is called respiration. Next one is circulatory system. So transport system, we have different types of fluids in our body. One of the example is blood. Okay, so within the circulatory system we are going to see about blood and its components. So within the circulatory system you can see heart, blood and other components. And as of you know, heart is one of the major and important organ, intermediate organ of blood circulatory system. It is very useful for the transportation. Blood circulatory system is going to be useful for the transportation of various components within our body through blood vessels. Okay, next one is excretory system. So excretory system can be defined as the process of removal of undigested waste from the body, that is called excretory system or excretion. Okay, next one is endocrine system. So endocrine system is specially useful for the secretion of hormones. Okay, so hormones are very important for control and coordination, to bring control and coordination in human beings. Okay, and last one is nervous system. So it includes a brain, neurons, everything. Okay, so these are different types of organ systems which occur only in human beings. Okay, but now we have the main, we are moving into the main concept is called photosynthesis. So photosynthesis which occurs only in green plants. Okay, so now we are going to see about the next slide is called, yes, okay, so nutrition. Yes, now we are moving into the main concept is called nutrition. Okay, so as of you know, nutrition can be defined as the process of intaking of all nutrients. Yes, you can see here, nutrition can be defined as the process of intaking of all the nutrients, that is called a nutrition process. Okay, so here we can get one doubt, how the nutrients has been prepared, how we can get the nutrients. Yes, we can get the nutrients from plants which can prepare food material by photosynthesis process. Okay, so now we are coming into the main content is called photosynthesis process. Okay, so based upon nutrition, based upon photosynthesis, nutrition is classified into two types. Okay, one is called autotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition. Okay, so autotrophic nutrition can be defined as the type of nutrition in which plants can prepare their own food. Plants can prepare their own food by a special process we can call photosynthesis. photosynthesis. Okay, so such type of nutrition is called autotrophic nutrition. Okay, so autotrophic nutrition can be defined as a type of nutrition in which plants can prepare their own food material in presence of sunlight. That is called photosynthesis. So by photosynthesis, living organisms can prepare their own food material. Such type of nutrition is called autotrophic nutrition. Okay, and the organisms involved in this autotrophic nutrition are called autotrophs. Okay, and the second type of nutrition is called heterotrophic nutrition. Okay, so heterotrophic nutrition can be defined as it is a type of nutrition in which they can get, living organisms can get food from other organisms. Okay, so we can living organisms can get food material from other organisms by different methods. So they can't have the ability to prepare food. That is called heterotrophic nutrition. Okay, so best example for heterotrophic nutrition is animals and human beings. So as of you know, human beings, we can't prepare food. Okay, so that's what we depends upon plants for getting a food material. That's what we are considered as heterotrophs. And such type of nutrition occurs in our body is called heterotrophic nutrition. Okay, so this is the basis of two types of nutrition. Okay, now we can see about the main concept is called photosynthesis process. Okay, so just now already I told that photosynthesis is a basic life process which occurs in plants. Okay, so photosynthesis is a basic life process which occurs only in plants. Okay, Namma. So it is a basic life process, very important basic life process which occurs only in plants. Okay, and photosynthesis can be defined as it is a basic life process in which all green plants can prepare their own food. All plants can prepare their own food in presence of light. That is called a photosynthesis. Okay, so photosynthesis can be defined as it is a complex photochemical reaction. That means photochemical reaction in the sense light dependent reaction. Okay, so photosynthesis occurs only under the presence of light. Okay, so it is a complex photochemical reaction in which plants can prepare their own food material in presence of sunlight. That is called photosynthesis. Okay, so for photosynthesis, four factors are required essentially for plants. These factors are classified into external factors and internal factors. Okay, so external factors in the sense, the factors, the components which come from outside to inside of the plant, that is called external factors. Okay, the factors which come from outside to inside of the plant is called external factors. Okay, so these external factors that include carbon dioxide and sunlight. Okay, so these are the two external factors which are essentially required for photosynthesis. Okay, next one is internal factors. Okay, so internal factors can be defined as the factors which are already associated with the plants and plant parts, the components which are already associated or connected with the plant or plant parts, that is called internal factors. Okay, so these internal factors, it includes chlorophyll and water. Okay, so now we can see how these four factors has been utilized by the plants for photosynthesis. Yes, first of all, you can see external factors. So first one is called carbon dioxide. Okay, so as of you know, carbon dioxide is one of the external factor. So this carbon dioxide has been taken by the plants through a small holes present in the leaf. Small holes or small pores present in leaf. Okay, so these small pores are called very important. It's called stomata. The small pores you can call as stomata. Okay, so leaf, it consists of very small holes or small pore-like structures. Okay, so these small holes or small pore-like structures we can call stomata. Okay, so through the stomata, the carbon dioxide has been taken, which is utilized for plants for the process is called photosynthesis. Okay, that is in taking up another component is called carbon dioxide. Okay, and the next component for photosynthesis is called sunlight. okay. So as of you know, direct sunlight will be fallen on the leaf. So during photosynthesis, chlorophyll, which is present in the leaf, it has the ability to convert light energy into chemical energy. Okay, so during photosynthesis, light energy which is trapped by sunlight by the leaf of chlorophyll, it can convert light energy into chemical energy. Okay, so that is in taking of direct sunlight by the leaf. Okay, next, internal factors. These include chlorophyll and water. So as of you know, chlorophyll is the green color pigment. Okay, chlorophyll is the green color pigment which is present in the leaf, which is present in the chloroplast of the leaf. Okay, so chloroplast is green color plastids present in the leaf. Okay, so within the chloroplast, chlorophyll is the essential pigment present in the leaf, chloroplast of leaf. Okay, so this chlorophyll is mainly useful in photosynthesis process of the leaf. Okay, next one is water. So water is one of the water is one of the essential factors required for photosynthesis, and this water has been taken by the leaf, this water has been taken by the plant, which is required for photosynthesis through roots. Okay, so these are the four factors required for photosynthesis, and how these four factors has been utilized by the plants for the process is called photosynthesis. Okay, now we can see the balanced equation of photosynthesis, very important in NEET point of view as well as board examination. Okay, so we need four factors for photosynthesis. Okay, so now we got four factors: carbon dioxide, water, sunlight and chlorophyll. Okay, so by utilizing these four factors, for photosynthesis, plants can prepare the food material, and the prepared food material is preserved in the form of glucose. So C6H12O6 is the formula of glucose. So glucose is one of the byproduct which is going to be prepared by the plants by photosynthesis process. So along with the glucose, the other byproducts which are released by photosynthesis are oxygen and water. Okay, so this is net equation of photosynthesis. Okay, so the next we are going, next slide we are moving here is called, yes, very important. First of all, just now I told, leaf is mainly involved in photosynthesis process. Okay, leaf is mainly involved in photosynthesis process. So you can get one question that why leaf only involved in photosynthesis? Because the essential pigment required for photosynthesis is chlorophyll. So the chlorophyll is pigment required for photosynthesis, we can consider as chlorophyll. Okay, so this chlorophyll is present only in leaf. Okay, this chlorophyll which is present only in leaf, it is not present in anywhere. So that's what leaf is mainly involved in photosynthesis process. Okay, yes, now we can see here, this is the structure of leaf, external structure of leaf. Okay, this is external structure of leaf, or LS of leaf, LS. So LS means longitudinal structure. Okay, LS of leaf or external structure of leaf. Okay, so this is external view of leaf. Okay, so now we can see here, so when we observe the LS of leaf or external structure of the leaf which is required for photosynthesis, or so it consists of various parts. So this is the leaf. So the place at which leaf is formed on the stem, that place is called petiole. Okay, so petiole means satimadhya. Yes, petiole. So petiole, it connects leaf to the stem. Okay, so we can see the formation of leaf on the stem. So the place at which leaf is exactly formed on the stem, that exact place we can call as petiole. Okay, and next one, the tips of the petiole we can call as stipule, Okay, next one is, here we can see the green color part of the leaf. So this is all green color part of the leaf. Okay, so the green color part of the leaf we can call lamina. Okay, that green color part of the leaf we can call lamina. Okay, so this lamina, it consists of chloroplast, with chlorophyll. Okay, so because of the presence of chloroplast in chloroplast with chlorophyll, this lamina is mainly involved in a special process, just that is we are going to discuss now. Here is main is called photosynthesis. Okay, so the main part of the leaf which is involved in photosynthesis is called as lamina. Okay, so this is green color part is called lamina. Okay, next one is middle part of the leaf, this middle. So this middle part of the leaf which divides leaf into two equal halves, the middle part of a middle portion of the leaf which divides leaf into two equal halves, that is called lamina. This we can call midrib. Midrib, the middle part of the leaf which divides leaf into two equal halves, that is called a midrib. Okay, next one, from midrib we got new branches like this, new branches. Okay, main branches. So these main branches which we got from midrib are called veins. Veins. Okay, and from veins we got again new branches like this. These are called veinlets. Okay, so the sub branches which are produced from veins are called veinlets. Okay, so the last part, this we can call as apex of the leaf, apex. Okay, so this is about the external structure of the leaf. Okay, next we are going for next one is very important, internal structure of leaf. Yes, here we are going to see internal structure of leaf. Okay, yes. Yes, we are going to say about internal structure of leaf. Okay, so this internal structure of leaf we can also call as TS of leaf. Okay, so internal structure of leaf we can also call as TS of leaf. Okay, so the full form of TS is transverse section. Transverse section. Okay, so just now we have seen about LS of leaf, that is nothing longitudinal section. Okay, so here TS of leaf or internal structure of leaf, anyone I can say. So the TS of leaf in the sense transverse section. Okay, if we cut the leaf horizontally we can see the leaf, so that is called TS of leaf, transverse section of leaf. Okay, so now we can see TS of leaf, this is very important in NEET concern as well as a board examination. Okay, now we can see here TS of leaf. So this is about TS of leaf. When we observe the TS of leaf, it consists of two cells. This is called upper epidermis. Upper epidermis. Okay. Okay. So the top one we can call upper epidermis and the bottom one we can call lower epidermis. Upper epidermis and lower epidermis. Okay. So now we can see here this upper epidermis and lower epidermis. So this upper epidermis is covered with a small membrane like structure like this. This we can call as cuticle. Cuticle. Okay, so the upper epidermis of the leaf which is covered with a one membrane, single membrane layer, that is called as cuticle. Okay, so upper epidermis and lower epidermis, upper epidermis is covered with a small membrane like structure, that we can call as cuticle. Okay, and the main function of cuticle is it can give protection to the leaf from predators. Okay, next one is upper epidermis, it consists of tightly packed cells like this, tightly packed cells. So upper epidermis, it consists of tightly packed cells, tightly packed cells without intercellular space, intercellular space. So upper epidermis, it consists of tightly packed cells without intercellular space. Okay, so these tightly packed cells without intercellular space, so without intercellular space means nothing but here there is no space between the cells. Once you observe here in two rows there is no space between the cells. Okay, there is no space, so this we can call absence of intercellular space. Okay, absence of intercellular space. Okay, and this type of cells which are present in TS of leaf in upper epidermal layer, thus type of cells, tightly packed cells which are present in upper epidermis of the TS of leaf without intercellular space, the type of cells are called as palisade parenchyma cells. Palisade parenchymal cells or parenchyma cells, anyone can say. Okay, so the upper epidermis, it consists of tightly packed cells without intercellular space. Okay, so the tightly packed cells without intercellular space of upper epidermis we can call as palisade parenchyma cells. Okay, Now we can see here lower epidermis. So lower epidermis we have loosely packed cells, loosely packed cells, loosely packed cells with space, intercellular space. Okay, so loosely packed cells with little bit intercellular space. That means the cells are present not tightly. So somewhat some gap is going to be present. Once you can see here the diagram, here we have little bit gap. Okay, little bit of gap. So these cells which are present in lower epidermis with the presence of small space, that is called spongy parenchyma cells. Spongy parenchymal cells. Okay, so now we can see the differentiation. So upper epidermis we have tightly packed cells without intercellular space, that is called parasitic parenchyma cells. Lower epidermis they consist of loosely packed cells with intercellular space. So that type of cells with small space in lower epidermis, that is called spongy parenchyma cells. So parasitic parenchyma cells are spongy parenchyma cells. Okay, next one is in lower epidermis of the TS soft leaf, they have a small space. Small space. Okay, this small space present in lower epidermis we can call stomata. Very very important, stomata. Okay, so during photosynthesis, this through the stomata gases will diffuse. Okay, during photosynthesis, just now we had discussed about photosynthesis and the factors required for photosynthesis. So carbon dioxide is one of the factor required for photosynthesis. Okay, so that carbon dioxide has been taken by the leaf through small hole like structure, that is called stomata. So this stomata is present in lower epidermis of the TS of leaf. Okay, and so through the stomata carbon dioxide is entered, and that carbon dioxide is preserved, that carbon dioxide is preserved or deposited in the form of the small space, that is called air space. Okay, so carbon dioxide has been taken by the leaf through stomata. So that carbon dioxide is entered downwards to upward and it is deposited in the form of air space. Okay, here you have mentioned air space. Okay, so that is about air space. Okay, and next one, in lower epidermis we have small space circle stomata. So these stomata are surrounded by kidney shaped cells. Here we have stomata are surrounded by kidney shaped cells, kidney shaped cells. So that kidney shaped cells which can surround the stomata are called god cells, god cells. Okay, so stomata surrounded by kidney shaped cells are called god cells. Okay, so these god cells are very important to open and closing of the stomata. Okay, these god cells are very important in opening and closing of the stomata. Okay, so as of you know, stomata functions. So stomata is useful in exchanging of gases, intaking of carbon dioxide, releasing of oxygen to outside after photosynthesis. That is one of the process of stomata, exchanging of gases. Okay, one more function of stomata is it is also useful in transpiration process. Transpiration. So if any excess water is present in the leaf, that excess water is eliminated to outside in the form of water vapor. So removal of excess water from inside to outside of the leaf, and at the same time when there is no water in leaf, so that water is entered from outside to inside of the leaf. So that is called intaking and releasing of excess water to outside. Okay, so in transpiration process, this is going to be stomata is going to be very important, and stomata is also useful in exchanging of gases. So stomata, opening and closing of stomata is influenced by these kidney shaped cells are called god cells. Very very important. Okay, god cells. Okay, next one, just you can see middle of the TS of leaf, here we have the two tissues are called xylem and phloem. So this we can call xylem, this tissue we can call xylem. As of you know, xylem main function is it is useful to supply water and minerals. Okay, as of you know, xylem is very important to supply water and minerals for the plants. Okay, so water is essential. So earlier we have discussed photosynthesis four factors. So water is also one of the essential factor required for photosynthesis. So that water which is essential required for photosynthesis has been uptaken by this xylem. Okay, so that xylem will provide water and minerals for the plants for photosynthesis. Okay, and next one, here we have the phloem tissue. So this is called phloem tissue. Here just below the xylem we have phloem tissue. Okay, so this phloem tissue is one more the complex tissue of the plants. Okay, one of the complex tissue also within the TS of leaf, you have two complex tissues in plants, xylem and phloem. So xylem is useful to conduct water and minerals, phloem is useful to preserve the food material. So after the photosynthesis, glucose has been formed. So that glucose which is formed after photosynthesis process is converted into starch. Okay, and finally that starch is preserved in the form of phloem. Okay, so this is about the complete process of photosynthesis and how the factors has been taken by photo leaf for the photosynthesis process. Okay, so this is about the internal structure of the leaf. Okay, next one we can see here, very important cell organelle we can call as chloroplast. Okay, so now we have discussed about leaf, internal structure, external structure, everything we have seen, and the main component, the main pigment required for photosynthesis, the main pigment required for photosynthesis is called chlorophyll. Okay, so chlorophyll is the green color pigment. Okay, pigment means nothing but color substance. Okay, chlorophyll is the green color pigment, and that chlorophyll which is green color pigment, it is present in chloroplast. Okay, so chloroplasts are a type of plastids. Present in plants. So within the plants we can see different plastids: chloroplast, chromoplast, leucoplast, different types of plastids, annuloplast, different types of plastids. Okay, so one of the type of plastids are called chloroplast. Okay, so chloroplasts are in green color because of the presence of chlorophyll. Okay, so the main objective or the main function of this chloroplast is, it is mainly considered the process, it is mainly involved in the process is called photosynthesis. It is mainly involved in the process we can call photosynthesis process. Okay, just now we have seen about photosynthesis equation, how the photosynthesis will occur in leaf, everything we have seen. Okay, so very delicate and microscopic part of the leaf which is involved in photosynthesis is called chloroplast. Okay, so this chloroplast we can see only with the help of microscope, that is compound microscope we are using. Okay, compound microscope or light microscope. So by using this microscope we can see chloroplast. Okay, so now we can see chloroplast structure. So this is about the structure of chloroplast. So when we observe the structure of chloroplast under the light microscope or compound microscope, we can see chloroplast is a disc shaped structure. Chloroplast is in disc shaped structure. Okay, disc shape, and some plants we can see chloroplast is in round or oval or spherical. Okay, that is the shape of the chloroplast. Okay, so disc shaped structure with two membranes. Chlorophyll, it has disc shaped structure with two membranes. Okay, so this is called external membrane, and this is called internal membrane. External membrane and internal membrane. So this is called outer membrane and this is called inner membrane. Okay, so two membranes. So chloroplast is disc shaped structure which consists of two membranes, outer membrane and the inner membrane. Okay, so that's what double membranous cell organelle which is present in plants is called chloroplast. Okay, so now we can see within the chloroplast we can see several, see here these like structures. Okay, within the chloroplast we can see several sac-like or thread-like structures. So these are all sac-like or thread-like structures. Okay, so these sac or thread-like structures that we can call as grana. Okay, several sac-like structures or thread-like structures which are present in chloroplast are called grana. Okay, so the next we are going to see here, so these are all called grana. Okay, next, within the chloroplast we can see the colorless fluid like this, so this colorless fluid which is present in chloroplast, we can call as stroma. Okay, so first of all you can see when we observe the chloroplast we can find several sac-like structures or thread-like structures which are present in chloroplast. That we can call as grana. Okay. And within the chloroplast, we can see the colorless fluid. So this all white color. This we can call stroma. Stroma. Okay. And now this grana is connected. This grana is connected with stroma. Yes, you can see here. Grana is connected with stroma here. So this by that we can call stroma lamellae. Stroma lamellae. Okay. So grana is sac-like structures or thread-like structures which are present within the chloroplast. A chlorophyll we can call grana. Okay. So within the chloroplast we can find colorless fluid that we can call stroma. So grana is connected with stroma by stroma lamellae. Okay, so this particular peculiar zone we can call as stroma lamellae. Okay, and within this chloroplast structure we can see the presence of lipid droplet, ribosomes and starch granule. So all these are present. Okay, so we can see this lipid droplet here. We can see lipid droplet and here the lipid droplet. Okay, so these are nothing but the oil glands or lipid glands, lipid layers or lipid glands which are present within the chloroplast are called lipid droplets. Okay, and next one is ribosomes. As of you know, we have studied about cell organelles earlier. So ribosomes are a type of cell organelles present in every cell. Ribosomes. Okay, as of you know, ribosomes are mainly involved in a process is called protein synthesis. Ribosomes are mainly involved in a special process is called protein synthesis. Okay, that's what ribosomes are also called, protein factories of the cell. Okay, and finally we have starch granule here. So now we can see how the starch granule has been formed. Okay, see here, within the grana we have a specific pigment that is called chlorophyll. So you can see grana, it is in green color. Okay, why it is in green color? Because the presence of chlorophyll pigment. Okay, so during photosynthesis light energy from sunlight has been trapped by the chlorophyll. Okay, and this light energy is converted into chemical energy during photosynthesis by grana of chlorophyll. Okay, finally by photosynthesis carbohydrates has been prepared. So glucose has been prepared. So this number of glucose molecules, so during photosynthesis glucose molecule has been prepared. Yes, by photosynthesis glucose is prepared as one of the end product, byproduct. Okay, so number of glucose molecules are combined together to form starch. So starch is a polysaccharide, as of you know, which is one of the type of carbohydrate. Okay, so polysaccharide is one of the type of carbohydrate which is formed by combining of number of glucose molecules. Okay, so here glucose molecule we have got by photosynthesis process. So these glucose molecules are combined together to form starch, which is called polysaccharide. So this starch is preserved in the form of starch granule. Okay, so that starch granule we are taking as directly food material. Okay, so this is the complete process of photosynthesis. Okay, and moreover, photosynthesis is an example of anabolic pathway. Okay, photosynthesis is an example of anabolic pathway. Why it is called anabolic pathway? Because simple molecules, so anabolism in the sense simple molecules are combined together to form large molecule, that is called anabolism or anabolic pathway. So here glucose is the monomer, that means only one glucose molecule. So glucose is the monomer, monosaccharide. Okay, so glucose is which one of the end product of photosynthesis, which is called monosaccharide. So that glucose molecules are going to be combined together to form large molecule is called starch. So here the conversion is simple molecules are converted into large molecule. So this process we can call as anabolism or anabolic pathway, which is one of the process of metabolism or metabolic pathway. Okay, so this is about structure of chloroplast. Okay students, so now we have finished about mechanism of structure of chloroplast. We have finished about the factors required for photosynthesis, the basis, everything we have finished, tears of leaf, everything we have finished. So by next class we are going to see about internal mechanism of photosynthesis and nutrition in human beings, everything we are going to see in the next session. Okay, so thank you for attending class. Thank you.